We're back in the Premier League and Newcastle United bounce back somewhat against Manchester City after going two consecutive losses in the Premier League. Although that win against City, third place City, was in the FA Cup, it's in the Premier League that Newcastle have got to keep pace with log leaders Manchester United. And they, as they prepare to take on West Bromwich Albion at the Hawthorns just a few days before taking on Genk in the Champions League. Both games have a degree of importance to them, that's for sure. Harry Kane has picked up a bit of a knock here, so he will not be involved today. Charlie Austin will come in then for Alan Shearer, Calvin Phillips for Sergio Busquets. Jude Bellingham certainly making a strong case for himself. Well, maybe he'll come in. Ferran Torres will come on for Gareth Bale. And that's about it. Shea Given comes on for Albon Lafont. West Brom playing the 4-3-3, and Andy Carroll once again be the danger man. Charlie Austin starting against his former club. Adama Traore, Calvin Phillips, Marco Verratti, Castona, all looking in good nick here. I wonder if I shouldn't give Martinez Quarta a bit of a break. Maybe bring Micah Richards in. Yeah, why not? Desai, Simon Kier. Yeah, that's enough changes for one day. I was going to start McManaman, but Castona looks really up for it. He might actually be a match winner for me. You never know. Scored two goals against West Bromwich Albion earlier in the season. One of them a phenomenal free kick as Newcastle walked out 2-0 winners. And he certainly looks up for it again today. The South African. Can Newcastle arrest the slide? They've lost the last two league games, conceded 4 shots on goal, and from those 4 shots conceded 4 goals. 2 shots in each game, resulting in 2 goals in each game. Marcel Desailly will lead the side out today. I know it might seem like it's just West Brom, but the implications are huge, because after we face Genk, we face the current log leaders, Manchester United. Charlie Austin, who's got a good goal ratio for Newcastle since joining them from West Brom, where he had a pretty good record against Newcastle United. And you can see Newcastle trying to rush West Brom. Calvin Phillips now trying to close off Conor Gallagher, and does so. Gives away the throw-in though. Calvin Phillips again. Oh, unable to keep it in there. Ferran Torres getting a start again today. Another one of those who hasn't quite hit the ground running. Marco Verratti will head that one away. Castona. Oof, so close there. Andy Carroll trying to turn his man but cannot do so. Simon Kier finds Verratti, who finds Calvin Phillips now. Tries to find Andy Cole. Oh my word, well blocked out there. Peltier in for the no man's land there. Marcel Desailly will do well to win this, and Andy Carroll has been called for a foul. Well, nothing in it there, was it? Verratti will fire this one forward. There were no Alan Shearer in the starting lineup today. Castona. Is Adama Traore now? Oh, Castona there, just missed his man. And Simon Kier does well. Simon Kier and Marcel Desailly, of course, familiar with each other from their time together at AC Milan. And you can see West Brom there giving the throw away. Hector just kicking the ball away. Referee says nothing wrong with that. And where are my players? Is Ferran Torres now trying to use his pace to get Newcastle going forward, and does so. Oh my word, just could never get the ball under control there, Torres. Despite making a positive run into the box, here's Andy Carroll. Simon Kier does well to just block off the channel there. And Andy Carroll, oh my goodness me, came heading in there with that big Andy Carroll size head. Dusan Savage there gets the cross in. And Andy Carroll unmarked, unchallenged. Heaven only knows why. Charlie Austin will try and win this one for Andy Cole, and does so. Andy Cole finds Ferran Torres down the flank here. Oh, Ferran Torres turns his man. Oh, unable to put the shot away. Good work there. And Andy Carroll wins that. Oh, crying out loud. And you can see West Brom doing their best Barcelona impression here. Touch and go, touch and go. Marcel Desailly will win that one for Castona, who will lose it immediately. Which is a load of bullshit. There's Andy Carroll, and well saved there, Shay Given. And Marco Verratti will pick it up. Races away from his man to find Marcel Desailly, who will find Castona. Oh, come on. He cannot make a single move here. Andy Carroll finds Livermore, and again West Brom shoveling Newcastle. And oh, what a save that was from Shay Given. And West Brom suddenly troubling Newcastle here. Andy Carroll has suddenly become Pele. Change his name to Cristiano Carroll, the way he's playing. There's Kevin Phillips now. Calvin Phillips tries to find Charlie Austin, who cannot lose his man. Newcastle United just a one shot on goal thus far, not really having the penetration they would like, and the title race is certainly slipping away. Charlie Austin tries to fight. Oh, Andy Cole. Andy Cole, can he get the shot off? Yeah, Andy Cole. No, he can get the shot off, but he cannot beat the keeper. Kier as well. Yes, Castona now. Oh, referee says no foul. Castona still going. And Nicole again, he scores. Terrific, determined run there from Castona. And Andy Cole answers the Newcastle call for a hero and puts that one away. My word. Newcastle really, really have to work hard here. Castona there battling hard in midfield. Past three players. And they just toe-ported into an area that he knew Andy Cole would be patrolling. Look at that, with three men around him. Castona took five players out of the game, really. With some quite terrific attacking midfield play. And Andy Cole, the clinical finisher, the predator in the box. Julio obliges with the finish. It's Dan O'Shea now. Baratti battles away with Livermore. Oh, and Adama Traore there can do nothing with it. There's Mateus Pereira there. Andy Carroll. Oh, come on, man. And Desailly, oh my goodness me. That's going to be a straight red. Yeah. I think the frustration there that Andy Carroll was just giving and going and going and giving, and he went sliding in. And Newcastle United now with half an hour to go are down to 10 men. Maybe. Yeah, I'm gonna have to sacrifice Andy Cole. Desailly, you can just get out of the way for a little bit. I'll leave there, and Andy Cole will make way for Lautaro Martinez will come into the back. And Newcastle now having to do just a little bit of a reshuffle here. Ferran Torres. It's Calvin Phillips now. Find Castona. Here's Torres. Oh! And Conor Gallagher with laser guided tackling there. And he sends Andy Carroll on his way. Again, Andy Carroll. Not really known for his pace, but all of a sudden, jet-heeled Andy Carroll. Look at this. Simon Kier will get Ferran Torres involved again. Who finds Andy Cole now, looking for some support. Here's Charlie Austin. Austin trying to find Castona. Oh, no go. And Newcastle will need a break in play before they can make the change. As it stands, Dusan Savage taken off it there by Ferran Torres, who will send a long ball forward and not a particularly good one in the end. Newcastle United still playing with just two centre backs. Livermore again now. Micah Richards. Calvin Phillips. Oh my goodness me, what the... Oh my goodness, what the hell? What the hell? Calvin Phillips here loses it, and Micah Richards. Oh my goodness me. They are doing everything they can. Sure, I tell you what, if this screw ass AI scripting doesn't leave me alone, I'm going to fling this controller at the screen. But as it stands, it's still 1-0. Calvin Phillips here, retrospectively, will get the free kick. Calvin Phillips there. The frustrations, man, I tell you. Let's see, what else can we change here? Castona can come off for Jude Bellingham and... Yeah, I'm going to bring on Steve McManaman as well. What the hell? 3 minutes. Have some fun, guys. Micah Richards is at the far post. He'll find Charlie Austin. And he's got some pace on him. The name of the game now is get the ball away from your own half. But he loses it straight away to another pinpoint tackle, and look at Andy Carroll go. Martinez Costa wins that, and Newcastle United will walk away 1-0 winners. A hard fought game here. Andy Cole, the goal scorer in the end. But a very, very tough game, and they will stay within touching distance of Manchester United. They did lose Marcel Desailly, and that one there is going to sting a little bit, but especially that well-timed goal. Really, finding victories is just so difficult at the moment. Ferran Torres here did well to turn Conor Gallagher in. Got the shot off and a great save from the goalkeeper. This is Andy Carroll here again. Got through and Carroll gave them no end of trouble. Carroll seems to play well above himself when he plays against Newcastle especially. I think just the idea of him being a former Newcastle player, and the fact that he's filling in for Charlie Austin, who moved on to Newcastle, could be any one of those factors, could have been all of them. And Andy Cole here got past his man. Couldn't put it away though. Goalkeeper, another miraculous save. Ha, unbelievable stuff. But in the end, Castona here, great piece of individual work. Left a string of West Brom players in his wake as he bombed forward there and set Andy Cole up for the what turned out to be the winning goal. Andy Cole did well to get back on side. Castner just delayed the pass for a second. And this was Marcel Desailly with a late tackle on Andy Carroll. And that was straight red for him. Mateus Pereira there, the wall doing its job. And so it'll end Newcastle United 1-0 winners away from home at West Bromwich Albion, just barely hanging on, keeping touch with the log leaders. Chelsea with a good win over Blackburn Rovers. Manchester United, slim 1-0 win over Southampton, and wins. Ooh, Liverpool lose at home to Tottenham. How about that? An Arsenal draw, and they drop yet more points. Manchester City with a good win there. So Liverpool now falling 9 points behind the log leaders. Arsenal, who at the turn of the year were something like 17-0. Since then, they've had a string of poor results, 4 losses, 4 defeats. And it just hasn't happened for them, and it's been a huge swing about there. They were 4 points clear at one point, and now 7 points off the top of the table. Wow, has there ever been a more Arsenal thing than that? West Brom now, bottom of the table. And they certainly put up a good fight, but the champions come here on top. Join me next time as we report to the Champions League away to Genk. Well, I believe I Swiss side, I think. So to Switzerland we go. Thanks for watching, guys. Cheers.